In order to continue our exposition, let me remind you notion of inner product or scalar product in linear vector space. Let A, B, and C be some vectors and alpha complex scalar. Inner product is a mapping from pair of vectors A and B to a complex scalar with the following four properties. It's conjugate symmetric, mean when we swap A and B, the result will be complex conjugate of the previous one. It is distributive. So A inner product with B plus C is A inner product with B plus A inner product with C. It is linear with respect to multiplication by a scalar. Alpha A inner product with B is alpha multiplied by inner product of A with B. And it also positive definite, mean inner product of A with itself is greater or equal to zero, and it is zero if and only if A is a zero vector. Having inner product, one can also define a norm of a vector, just square root of inner product of vector with itself. Now we will look at three examples of inner product. First example, let A and B be n-dimensional complex vectors. Then inner product of A with B is just sum of element-wise products of component of A, AI, by conjugate, complex conjugate, BI. Another examples, suppose that we have complex functions of real variable on interval T. We define inner product as integral over T of product of the first function F with the complex conjugate of the second function G. The third example, assume we have two real n-dimensional vectors and symmetric n by n matrix Q, which is positive definite. We define inner product of xy with index q as x transpose qy. I suggest you to show at home that all four properties of inner product, which we mentioned in previous part, are satisfied. Now, let us talk about Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization procedure. Given set of vectors x1 till xn, which are linearly independent, we will obtain set of orthogonal vectors y1 to yn, which span the same linear subspace as the original system of vectors x. And the procedure is relatively simple. The first vector y1, we just take it coincides with x1. It's given here. Y2 can be obtained by we take vector x2, project it onto direction y1, and subtract the projection. The difference will be orthogonal to y1, and this will give us the second vector. The procedure is written here. So we subtract from x2 its projection. So in order to get projection, we normalize vector y1, take inner product, and this number multiply by vector of direction y1, by normalized vector. In order to obtain y3, we can continue in following way. We take vector x3 and project it into onto subspace spanned by vectors y1 and y2. Here is the projection. And the difference between vector x3 and its projection will give us vector y3, which is orthogonal to subspace spanned by y1 and y2, so it is orthogonal to each of those vectors. And we continue so on. In general, to get new vector yk, we subtract from xk its projection on all components of yi, orthogonal vectors yi, which we already obtained. So we take inner product with yi and divide by y squared, because of those two terms in denominator, we just put together and multiply by vector yi. And this is a general formula of Gram-Schmidt orthogonalization.